Preparations for the start of voter registration on Monday are in full swing. More malls are participating in the Philippine Poll Body's Register Anywhere program. This is in a bid to get more voters to register. Our correspondent, Victoria Tulad, now on the line with that story. Victoria?
That's correct, Ron. More malls will participate in the Register Anywhere program, or RAP, of the Commission on Elections as the poll body signed a memorandum of agreement with three mall chains this morning. Yesterday, COMELEC also signed an agreement with another mall. This brings to 170 the number of malls that COMELEC has already partnered with, or RAP. It hopes more will participate. Under the said program, Filipinos can register as new voters, reactivate their account, transfer registration and correct or update their information in partner establishments such as malls, schools, private companies, and government offices. The poll body hopes to encourage the public to register by giving them a convenient experience. Voter registration in the country is from February 12 to September 30. Registration for Filipinos abroad is already ongoing and will last until September 30 as well. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia emphasized that this will not be extended. He also warned the public from committing double or multiple registrations, which is an election offense. An election offense is punishable with imprisonment of 1 year up to 3 years and perpetual disqualification from holding public office. Garcia remarked that even if a voter did not intentionally violate the law, ignorance cannot be excused. This afternoon, COMELEC also signed a memorandum of understanding with various groups to help educate the youth about the elections, gather help in fighting misinformation and disinformation, and encourage them to register and vote. Ron?
Victoria Tulad with that story. Thanks. Over 4 billion pesos worth of illegal drugs destroyed in the Philippine province of Cavite. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency disposed of the drugs through thermal decomposition. The contraband included 725 kilograms of methamphetamine. They were seized in various anti-illegal drug operations by the PIDEA, the Philippine National Police, and the National Bureau of Investigation. Authorities now vowing to continue their crackdown on illegal drug syndicates. Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatalian urging an effective rollout of comprehensive sexuality education. Gatalian also seeks an investigation into the rising number of teen pregnancies and HIV infections among the youth. Now, this comes as the country logs a rise in pregnancies among girls below 15 years old between 2021 and 2022. The number of teenage pregnancies rose 35% to over 3,100. The United Nations Population Fund earlier warned girls who begin childbearing before they turn 18 are at an increased risk for poor health outcomes and are vulnerable to domestic violence. The Philippines' gross international reserves level as of January 2024 stands at $103.4 billion. That's slightly down from the December 2023 level of $103.8 billion. Still, the Philippine Central Bank says the latest GIR level represents a more than adequate external liquidity buffer equivalent to 7.7 months' worth of imports and goods and payments of services. The BSP adds it's also about six times the country's short-term external debt. Back on the line, Lady Vicencio, to tell us more about the anti-red tape authorities' digitalization efforts. Lady?
Yes, Ron, the anti-red tape authority challenged local government heads to be fully compliant in the Electronic Business One-Stop Shop or eBOS system. eBOS is an online portal that streamlines services for business registration, such as submission of permit applications, online payments, and the electronic issuance of documents. ARTA Director General Ernesto Perez said, aside from attracting big-ticket investments, digitalization efforts on processing of business permits will mostly benefit MSMEs. He said that the eBOS system will allow businesses to apply for permits in the comfort of their offices and homes, and payment of fees should be done online up to the printing of their permits. Perez also called on government units to comply despite challenges on internet connectivity and lack of resources, saying that implementation of the program is possible if local chief executives have the political will to comply. Data shows 633 out of 1,637 LGUs, or not even half of the LGUs, have rolled out the system, but only 26 LGUs are fully certified EBOS. ARTA is targeting to onboard an additional 200 or 120 LGUs on the EBOS system this year. Perez also reiterated the importance of being on board the EBOS system to hit the government's target of cutting business permit processing to 10 minutes. To achieve this goal, the authority has suggested pre-approval of business permit while pertinent documents are being processed and submitted within a set timeline. Ron?
Lady Vicencio with that report. Thanks, Lady.